Hi, I'm Becky Bagley, Director of the Nurse-Midwifery Education Program at East Carolina University, and I'm going to talk with you today about fetal heart rate decelerations and the physiology behind them. First of all, we have variable decelerations, and variable decelerations are caused by cord compression. The cord can be compressed by the baby grabbing onto it, or the umbilical cord could be in between the baby's body and the uterus, and so the maternal position can make a difference with that. Okay, so variable decelerations are called variables because they vary in shape and they can vary in where they occur in relationship to the contraction. Variable decelerations can be U-shaped, W-shaped, or V-shaped. They typically drop quickly and return to the baseline quickly. Variable decelerations will oftentimes have shoulders around the deceleration, which means the heart rate will accelerate before it drops, and then it accelerates again before it comes back to the baseline. The reason for this is because of the physiology of the umbilical cord. So the umbilical cord has two arteries and one vein. Opposite of how the body works after the baby's born, the arteries carry the wastes from the baby back to the mother, and the vein carries the oxygenated blood from the mother to the baby. So the vein is the larger vessel, it's more thin-walled, and so it's more easily compressed. And so typically with cord compression, the vein is compressed first, which causes a sympathetic response in the baby's heart rate, causing that fight or flight reaction, which accelerates the heart rate. And that's what causes the initial shoulder prior to the deceleration. And then baroreceptors kick in, and that's what drops the heart rate down. And then once the pressure is released off the umbilical cord, the heart rate accelerates again before it returns to the baseline. Okay, early decelerations are caused by head compression. They are also called mirror images of the contraction because as the contraction starts to rise, the heart rate will drop. And as the contraction starts to fall, the heart rate increases. So if you were to cover up the contraction and the deceleration at the same time, you wouldn't even see the deceleration. It occurs at the same time as the contraction. So early decelerations are a normal type of deceleration. It is a sign that the mother is probably progressing well in labor and needs to have her cervix examined as it may be time for her to start pushing. The last type of deceleration is called late decelerations, and these are the decelerations that we worry about. As the contraction starts to increase and gets to the peak of the contraction, that's when the heart rate will start to drop. And as the contraction decreases, the heart rate slowly begins to increase, but is still on its way back up to the baseline as the contraction is over. Late decelerations are caused by uteroplacental insufficiency. And what this means is that there's a poor transfusion between the uterus and the placenta, so the baby is not getting the oxygen that it needs. Here you can see a cross-section of the placenta, and within the intervillous space, which is that blue part, you can see the spiral arteries, which carries the deoxygenated blood from the baby back to the mother. And then the mother's blood vessels pick up the deoxygenated blood, but also take oxygenated blood from greater concentration of the mother to the lesser concentration of the baby. To help you understand this, I'm going to use my hands. If you would imagine this hand being the blood vessels within the placenta that are coming from the mother, and this hand is the blood vessels going to the baby. The oxygen goes from greater concentration of mom to the lesser concentration of the baby. When mom has a contraction, all of these blood vessels are going to be compressed, and so the baby's not getting any oxygen at all during the contraction. As soon as the contraction's over, the blood vessels are released and the baby's able to breathe again. When you have uteroplacental insufficiency, for some reason, some of those blood vessels are clotted off. This could be because of hypertension, it could be because of diabetes, it could be because mom's a smoker, or possibly she's post-dates. And so now when you throw a contraction on top of this baby, instead of the baby getting a good deep breath to help him go through the contraction, it's as if he gets a small breath. And by the time he gets to the peak of the contraction, the baby realizes he doesn't have any more oxygen on board. And that's when his heart rate begins to fall. And then the contraction lets up, and the baby gets his oxygen again. And at that point is when the heart rate slowly starts picking back up. Thus, the deceleration occurs late in the contraction.
I hope this was helpful in your understanding of the physiology behind decelerations.